Hello and welcome to another video. I'm Kytia Lamore and thank you for joining me today as we're talking about my prom story time. If you want to know more about my prom night and also how I got this face together, then I would keep watching if I were you. Prom! Prom is so exciting, isn't it? Are you going to prom? Are you old enough for prom? Are you too old for prom? I have a prom story and I wanted to do like a makeup look that you can recreate yourself, as well as talk a little bit about my prom experience, especially from a Christian young woman perspective. I didn't go to junior prom, but I did go to senior prom. This is not the look that I had. My mom actually did my hair and makeup for that, but I'm gonna get started with putting stuff on my face. I'll link everything below so that I don't have to keep interrupting the story, and it's gonna be really long if I do that. So first I'm gonna do my foundation, and this one broke on me. It was a pump and it fell on the floor, so now I have to do this and be super weird. So my prom experience was interesting. I liked prom. I wasn't ever really the girl who went to all the dances. I went because my friends went and my mom encouraged it to be social and get some high school experiences, and I never regretted going at all. But prom was like a big deal, obviously. But something that happened soon before the prom, it's awkward to talk about this because I'm married now and I don't want to talk about other guys that I used to like, but this is just life. Obviously, I've liked people, so I'm just gonna talk about it. So the guy that I really, really, really liked in high school, he ended up moving away probably 6 months before prom. So towards the beginning of the school year, senior year, he moved away. I told you guys that I stopped dating. Probably my sophomore year was the last boyfriend I ever had. I was a sophomore, he was a senior, so he was long gone and doing stuff by the time I was a senior. But I purposely stopped dating because I noticed I was attracting the wrong guys, people who had like, I don't know, they were just very kind of quick to be angry, and even though they had a sense of humor and everything, it was just very like, I don't know, they were just kind of passionate, aggressive. I don't know, and I would just say very manipulative. That's probably the word. And I'm really glad I made that commitment when I did, because it would have been bad. I just know it would have been bad. And I'm thankful for my mom. She didn't say I couldn't date, it was my choice. Once I was 16 or so, she was like, you can have a boyfriend, but obviously there's rules, there's guidelines, I want to know him. And you guys can't just be going off doing your own thing. Like, we had curfews and all of that. But after like that experience, and even like my boyfriend when I was a sophomore, I dated him because people kind of wanted me to. I knew nothing about him. And then it was like that thing where in high school, sometimes your friends will let your crush know that you like them because you don't want to be rejected. So you're just like, oh, go tell them I like them. And it's just like, boy, you was almost a man. You're like 17 years old. You can't ask somebody out, like you can't say you like them. So his friends were like, oh, he really likes you and you should think about it. And I was like, well, I wasn't really thinking much about having a boyfriend even, but then I just kind of felt like I should because they were so adamant about it. And I had just kind of got out of a weird we're friends but we like each other kind of thing already, where the guy was like, I have no intentions of being monogamous. I'm gonna do what I wanna do. And I was like, dude, you pursued me. I thought we were going to be a thing and you're just like, nope, I just wanna be around other girls and do what I wanna do. So that had just ended. And then this other guy came along, the one who was a senior, and he was like, I like you. So I was like, okay, I guess this can be a thing. So I just let it happen. And we were dating, I don't even know how long, like a couple months. It didn't work out. I ended up breaking up with him. But the other guy that I was like, I'm not dating, I don't want to do that anymore, it's just not worth it, it's too many feelings, it's too much drama, like I don't want to do it, and I'm not even doing it for the right reasons. I'm like, oh, they like me, so I guess I should like them back. Or it would just be like, oh, I feel pursued, I feel special, so I'm going to like them back so that I can have somebody, because everybody has a boyfriend, like everybody's dating and going from one person to another, which you don't have to do. It's not even wise to do that. So I didn't do that anymore, but I did like a guy. He ended up moving away because when I was in high school, my stepdad was in the Navy. So a lot of kids in my school, they were from the Army, Navy, and Air Force. Their parents were in those careers. So a lot of people would just up and move in the middle of the school year, which is like, I'm glad that never happened to me. My stepdad worked on a submarine, so there weren't a lot of places submarines were, so he got to keep signing up every 2 years to stay in Hawaii, which added some stability, which I'm very grateful for, because that would have been really hard to just pick up and move away at different times of the year. Like in the middle of a school year, that's kind of a lot. So this guy I liked, he moved away. So one of my friends, he was like, yeah, so do you have a date for the prom? And I was like, no, I think I'm just gonna go with my friends. And he was like, well, would you wanna go with me? And I was like, okay, that's nice. Like, I'll have a date. It's kind of cool. I had no feelings for him whatsoever. I don't even know if he had feelings for me. But it was just like, let's go as friends and we don't got nobody else, so. And he was a nice guy and my mom actually knew his parents. My mom felt comfortable with me going with him because she knew he was gonna get in deep trouble if he tried anything with me, because they were not playing that whole like, ooh, it's your prom night, you know, go and have a great time and get a hotel room. And no, they were like, you need to be home by a certain time. And that's what I did. And it was just like a, almost like a relief, like, oh, that's cool. I don't have to go with someone who I have all these crazy feelings for, or I hope they like me, or like they trying to do things that I'm not comfortable with. It was just very platonic and I made that very clear. So another thing that happened with that, with my dress, my mom, we were just talking about this the other day, and she was like, I'm glad that we're the type of parents, like, we're not gonna take out a loan, like, to get your prom dress. This is not your wedding, this is prom, it is a dress. I think we looked at some places and I might have tried on some things, and I actually was in a prom dress fashion show in school, so I got to see like, oh, this is how much this costs and this is how much this costs, this is really beautiful. But what ended up happening is I had a dress from an 8th grade dance, and it was a simple long black evening gown. And what I did was I went to Claire's, which is a jewelry store, and they have those everywhere, so you should probably know about that. And I got some necklaces, and I literally just sewed the necklace onto different detailed parts of the gown. I think below the bust and the straps, and I actually sewed them onto my black shoes too. And I thought I was jazzy, and I was like, I didn't have to spend nothing but like maybe 10, 15 bucks on this dress. And I was fine with that. I'm like, it's one day and nobody else knows. Like, I wasn't in Hawaii when I was in 8th grade. They're not gonna know that I reused my 8th grade dance dress, and I'm glad that it still fit and everything too. So it turned out really great. And if you do have a tight budget for things, or you're not even sure if you can go at all, I've done a lot of photo shoots and I don't spend a ton of money on the things that I wear. Nowadays brands are willing to collaborate with me on stuff, but before that I would just go to the thrift store and I would find some really, really cute stuff for a very decent price. And I think if you have one around you, just go and see what's there. Like, I've bought gowns at the store that probably should have been like hundreds of dollars, and some of them still had the tags on them. So that was my dress story. And as far as my hair and makeup, my mom was probably like, girl, and I mentioned this in my, it was like a chit chat, get ready with me, how I do my wash and go. So I cut off all my hair senior year, basically, because I was like, I don't want to do relaxer, I want to be a curly girl, blah, 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 blah. I probably had, I don't know, maybe 6 inches of hair at the time, all around. It was all one length because I just literally chopped off all the excess growth that was relaxed and straight and all stringy and very not healthy. So I cut off all my hair. So she was like, girl, why did you have to do this before prom? Couldn't you have waited? Like, I could have had a longer style. But my mom did a really good job. She did like a swoop bang and like had it pinned up so it kind of looked like it was longer than it was. So I'm glad that my mom, like, she literally went to school for cosmetology. And so she did hair, makeup, all of that as a profession when I was younger. So she knew what she was doing and I wasn't scared of that at all. I just felt good about it. But there are places that you can go to get your makeup done for free, like, let's say the mall, and you go to Sephora or some makeup counter in Macy's, and if you buy a certain amount of products, they'll do your makeup for free. So I know people who are grown who did that for like their birthday. Like, I'm turning 29, I went to Macy's and got my makeup done, I just had to buy like $50 worth of stuff. And that's a lot cheaper than hundreds of dollars for a makeup artist to come to you and do your makeup and everything. So I'm all about saving money, I'm all about being responsible with how you spend it. But if you do have the budget and your parents are like, let's go all out, let's get your hundreds of dollars worth of dresses, let's get your makeup and hair done, like, go for it if you have that. But if you don't, you don't have to feel bad about that at all. So that day my mom did my hair, my makeup, I got ready and then my date arrived and he came and I think we took a few pictures. I don't even know where those pictures are. This is back when people still used film cameras with you had to go and like develop the film and get those pictures. But yeah, I don't know where those pictures went, but I do have a picture from prom. I'm gonna insert into this so you can see what I looked like. Very simple, very elegant. Thanks, Mom, for doing that for me. So my date arrived, we got in the car. I wanna say we carpooled and traffic was so bad. I think it was a weekend, but I lived in Honolulu and we had to go to Waikiki, which is where the prom was. I don't even know, I feel like it was an hour that we went in the car and spent a lot of time in traffic, but it was all good. We were just having a good time chilling. It wasn't like a limousine or anything fancy. It was whatever car he had in high school and we didn't have to get dropped off by our parents, so it's fine. And then we got to the place, went inside, and like had a really great time. We danced the night away, and it wasn't like booty dancing. Like, man, when I tell you, you would think people was trying to get pregnant on the dance floor. Like, I feel like it's probably worse now, but even when I was going to prom in 2004, so that's 14 years ago, that can't be. Wow. 14 years ago I was at prom. So 14 years ago when I was at prom, it was booty all the time, booty on the dance floor, people grinding and bumping. I don't know how it was allowed because I believe there was chaperones. Maybe they were like, this is your last dance, do whatever you want to do, I don't care. But we were just like, man, doing like old school dances, and he was like picking me up and swinging me around. Well, not swinging me around, but like, oh, we're dancing and we're twirling, and it was just like funny. Like, we just wanted to have fun, and I think there was like a prom recap video where we were in it, like doing that kind of stuff, and I thought it was hilarious. Because there was no pressure, nobody was trying to impress anybody. It's like, I see you in math class, like, I know you, I know your mama, your daddy. Like, we're not trying to be all crazy about it. So the prom was great, we took pictures, we had a great time. I had friends there that we sat at the table with them. And it's very simple, it's like what, you eat food, you dance, and that's the whole prom. And we didn't really plan anything afterwards, but what had happened was, after prom, he was like, yeah, some of our friends, they got a hotel room. I think it was within walking distance or something. They got a hotel room in Waikiki. And I walked into the hotel room and I was like, first of all, it's really dark in here. And there was a lot of people, I want to say like 12 to 16 people in this room. Somebody's parents got them a hotel room. Parents, please stop doing that. This is not a joke. This is a PSA. Don't get your kids a hotel room on prom night. Don't set them up for that. Like, it's not appropriate. They're not adults doing their own thing. Somebody I know purposely like lost her virginity on prom night because it was like, he's my boyfriend and I love him and this will be a special night. And I believe there's even a movie. Right now it's gonna be May 2018. There's a movie about that where these girls make a pact. I haven't seen it, so I don't know like if there's any redeeming value, but basically it's just a lot of coarse language and a lot of sexual talk with these people who are like, they're playing teenagers, so I'm sure they're adults in real life, but they're playing teenagers and it's geared towards teenagers, and it's like, yeah, we're gonna lose our virginity on this night and it's gonna be amazing. And I mean, you should wait until marriage, and especially just being with someone you're in a committed, loving relationship as an adult, you know, you're married. But I know not everybody's gonna do that, but I feel like that's God's best plan for us, is to wait until we're married, because you develop a very strong attachment to this person that you are sleeping with. And so if you're doing that on prom night, especially if their whole goal is to take you to prom so that they can have, you know, sex with you, it's not gonna be the best thing for you at all. So that's my PSA on that. But yeah, it was very dark in that room. There was a lot of people. I think I smelled weed or something. We ended up, me and my prom date, we went out on the balcony and I was like, yeah, I don't want to be here. I don't want to be here at all. And he was like, okay, cool. I don't really want to be here either. It was sad. Like, in hindsight, it's like, they're just babies. This is sad. But even as a high schooler, I was like, this is very uncomfortable. There was a Jack in the Box down the street off the strip in Waikiki. And we literally just went there, got some food. So we're in line, like in our tuxedo and dress, and we weren't the only ones who went there. There's a lot of people actually. And we literally went across the street because it's like you have the strip and on the other side of the street is literally the beach. So we went across the street, sat on a bench, and we just talked for a while about life, about our parents, about like what are our plans after school. And it was just really nice to have that very casual experience. And so I'm just really glad that that was my experience. And, you know, it could have been a lot different, but I had a very strong relationship with my mother and developed a very strong relationship with God, and just knew what I wanted for my life and what I didn't want for my life. And just seeing people all doing the same things and just ending up heartbroken, I didn't think it was helping anybody. Trying to keep a boyfriend or talking about their little sexual adventures and everything, I didn't want anything to do with that. I feel like a lot of times we look for love and fulfillment and I guess value in people sometimes when we don't feel it at home and we just feel like lost and alone. And you're susceptible to doing a lot of things. Even the guy that I was talking about who moved away that I really like, his mom was like, y'all can do whatever. Like, he would be out on a school night at like 11 o'clock. And I remember him saying when I was like, my mom doesn't let me out past this time and I need to call her like every hour on the hour telling her I'm okay. Which now I get it, because people be getting snatched up and murdered and raped and stuff. So she was like, let me know every hour on the hour where you are. And if you're at someone's house, I need to know their parents' phone number. And it seemed extreme at the time, but he was like, I wish my mom cared that much about me, because he's just wandering the streets doing whatever he wants to do. And he had a sense of humor, so that's how I didn't know he was a sad, sad boy. But yeah, he was a very sad person, and I think part of him wanting to be with me was I was very positive and I wanted great things out of life, and my family was very close. I know that he wanted that and would hang around our house, and he really loved my mom. And my mom was nice to him, even though I'm sure for her she was like, if you don't get away from my daughter. But she was very patient to let me figure that out on my own after way too long. Way too long I was involved in that. And I'm thankful that he moved away. I'm thankful it didn't really go anywhere. And I'm thankful that my mom didn't force anything, because you know how sometimes you're like, but I love him and I want to stay with him forever. You just don't want me to be happy. I never really felt that for my mom. I saw personal examples of like, yep, I don't want to do that, so I'ma just do my own thing, focus on things that are important to building my future. And I was in the church choir. I was trying to be around people who had similar mindset as me. I think that really helped me a lot. Just feeling valued at home and feeling loved and being able to have those deep conversations with my mom about life in general and about just what does God expect from me? What does he want from me? What do you want from me? How do I do it, you know, when the world is saying you're crazy and that doesn't make any sense? It's one of the best things you can do, you know, developing a deep relationship with God and, you know, teaching that to your children. That's one of the most important things, the most important thing as a parent, you know, it's letting your children know about God, that he is real, and that he has rules and expectations, and that life with him is so much better than anything that we could do ourselves. So as far as after that dance, after college, my prom date and I, we saw each other maybe 2-3 times after that, because he lived very close to the area I had moved to. I moved to Eva Beach in Hawaii, and he was in that same city. And so there were a few times we went out with friends, went to the beach or went to hang out, but it was never anything like a relationship. So that was that. And he was a good guy, and I feel like there doesn't need to be this pressure about prom and just like falling in love at prom and doing whatever other people expect you to do. Girl, you fine. If you went with a group of friends, like, that's fine. It doesn't need to be a huge production. So I would like to know, what do you guys see as far as relationships and events and just feeling the pressure to be in a relationship, being married, have a date, have a prom date, go to these things? You may not even want to go to prom, you don't have to, but with the right people it can be really fun. But like, what are some of the pressures that you guys see nowadays? Like I said, it's been 14 years since I've been to prom, and it was still pretty hard. Like, we was just now getting cell phones. We didn't have Twitter, Instagram. I don't think social media was even a thing. People have these like really thought out prom proposals, and with like a professional photographer, and like, she said yes, she'll go to prom with me. And I think it's cute, but if you're feeling like you need to have all that, like, no, it is not that serious. And you don't have to feel like you're missing out. But what kind of things are you guys looking forward to with prom? Are you even going to prom? Did you go to prom? I would actually love to hear your stories about prom. Are there any things that you would want to share? Any advice you'd like to give to people who are watching this? But I hope you guys have a fantastic night or have had a fantastic night and just keep it very you. Like, you don't have to change yourself and become someone like unrecognizable when you go to the prom. Okay, so I'm back. My eyes are watery. I did my waterline too. Ah! And it always makes my eyes water so bad. So the other thing I'm going to do is add some glitter to the top. In high school, choose your friends wisely. Find people who literally have the same morals and values as you, because I promise you, even in the word it says, corrupt company will corrupt you. There's the analogy of the frog that's in the water, and it becomes like hotter and hotter, and before he even knows it, the water is boiling him alive. Because you get so used to sitting in that, even when the temperature's rising, you're not aware that that's happening to you. So then all of a sudden you're just like, where am I? How did I end up here? And I've seen it happen to a lot of people, you know, and it's only by the grace of God that that wasn't me. And I'm gonna tell you guys, I'm not gonna ask you if you wanna see this, but I'm gonna tell you guys about my purity story and how it was not perfect, because I think some people can look at other people's testimony like, oh, you saved yourself for marriage, oh, you never had temptation, oh, you never put yourself in a situation where you could sin. God saved me a few times from making some really bad mistakes and from ending up in circumstances that would have not allowed me to have this testimony. So I just say, wait for that video. There's definitely a reason that God says, you know, to keep the right friends around you and to walk toward wisdom and not away from it. And I'm glad that I had my mom. I'm glad that I made, you know, certain decisions in life, because it really did help me to be the woman that I am today and to avoid some things. Like, God can redeem a lot of things, but it's better if you just don't have to go through it. And I'm very fortunate to have the mom that I have, the God that I have, the husband that I have, and to be raised, just to be raised a certain way. And that's why I'm very, very, very adamant about how I raise my daughter and why I'll be homeschooling her and why, you know, I'm already like praying with her in the morning and having her read her little kid's Bible and making sure that she knows that God is the center of everything that we do. And knowing, you know, her knowing expectations and disciplining her because I love her. And I'm grateful that I had the example that I had. I know not everybody does, but even if you didn't, it's still possible that you can have a life that God wanted for you and that you can learn and read the word and have the right community around you where you're like, I don't want my kids to deal with what I went through. That's why I'm doing this right now. That's why I'm doing it differently. So you don't have to be ashamed of your past. You can move forward from it and don't allow anybody to make you feel ashamed and guilty for things that happened to you or for things that you just didn't do or did do. Like, today is a new day. God's mercies are renewed every morning. So just take, really believe that and take heart that it is available to you as well, and that you can provide that for your children and help them to sidestep and overcome and avoid some things, because we're raising the next generation and they're gonna need to be an influence, or they're gonna be very easily influenced. We need to be raising leaders and people who are willing to take a stand for the right things, and they can't do that if they don't have the tools. So let's give them the tools that they need today. So I'm back, I have my lashes on, and I did like a fun, I don't know, wispy, spiky, I don't really know how to call these, but I did like a fun, more fun look that kind of is exaggerated and stands out a little bit. And the last thing that we have to do is our lips. So I'm going to be using a lip pencil and then a liquid lipstick to go on top of that. You feel sassy when you got on a dark lipstick. And there you go. And now I'm gonna get ready to do my hair. So when I come back to you, I'll have all of my hair and makeup done and I will close it out. All right, so this is how it turned out. Thank you so much for watching this. I hope that you guys learned some things, spiritually and through makeup. Let me know in the comments below how your prom night was, or are you excited for prom? Are you about to go? Are you avoiding prom? Because that's cool too. But either way, let's start a conversation. I will try to respond to every single comment that you guys put out there the day this video goes live, and after that I'll be checking in throughout the week. But it's been a little bit harder to keep up with since my channel is growing. Thank you, Jesus, and thank you guys for being so supportive. So that being said, I will see you guys next time, and if you like things like hair, makeup, fashion, beauty, relationships, faith topics, I would subscribe if you haven't already. I want you to join the family, and also turn on your notifications if you haven't, so that you'll know exactly when I post a new video. And until next time, I hope you have a great week. God bless you, and I love you. Bye. This is what it's gonna be. I think it'll be fine. A makeup look that you could create. No, Siri. Oh my gosh. I was recording this whole time.